シンガポールのワンジョンインスティチューションからお越しいただきましたワン・ウィーテックさん、ダレン・リー・チリアンさん、指導はワン・チャク・ウー先生です。
Good afternoon judges, teachers and students. I am Wee Teck and he's Darren. We are 15 years old this year and we are from Hwa Chong Institution, Singapore. Today, we are very honored to present to you our project, which is titled Absorption of Phosphate Using LGD Calcium Carbonate Composites. As we all know, although the earth is mostly covered with water, only a mere 2.5% of them is red water, and they usually come in the form of lakes, rivers, and streams. Therefore, it is our most important to maintain the quality of this water body. However, currently due to industrialization, wastewater from agricultural and industrial sectors have introduced different chemical contaminants into surface and groundwater. Fertilizers, industries, laundries, and household washrooms have also introduced wastewater rich in phosphate ions. Although these ions are useful for plant growth, they may cause eutrophication when in excess. Furthermore, findings have shown that over 450 areas worldwide have experienced symptoms of eutrophication. Therefore, knowing the global scale of eutrophication, the question to be tackled is how do we mitigate this problem? Hence, in our project, we plan to synthesize alginate calcium carbonate composite beads, as well as investigate the effect of initial concentration of phosphate, absorbent dosage, and pH on the effectiveness of phosphate removal of our composite beads. So, we hypothesize that our alginate calcium carbonate composite beads are effective in removing phosphate, and this can be increased by higher pH or higher absorbent dosage prior to the experiment. So, our project is mainly divided into two phases. The first phase is the preparation of alginate calcium carbonate composite beads. Firstly, sodium alginate is dissolved in our water at a temperature of 80 degrees Celsius. Calcium carbonate powder was then mixed thoroughly with the above solution to get a homogeneous mixture. The suspension from the above step is then injected dropwise into 1 molar calcium chloride solution. Alginate calcium carbonate composite beads will be formed. The composite beads form were then left in calcium chloride solution and for 30 minutes for further solidification. They were then washed and dried overnight. The composite beads obtained have an average mass of 0.01 gram per bead and a diameter of ranging from 2 mm to 3 mm. Moving on to the next stage, which is the test on removal of phosphate. In order to investigate the effect of initial concentration of phosphate, absorbent dosage, and pH of the phosphate solution on the effectiveness of the phosphate removal, batch mode experiments were conducted. Alginate calcium carbonate composite beads were mixed with 25 ml of phosphate solution and shake for 1 day. The phosphate solution is then centrifuged and the supernatant was decanted. The supernatant was then analyzed to determine the concentration of phosphate using a colorimeter. To investigate the effect of initial concentration of phosphate, we prepare phosphate solutions of concentration 10 ppm to 50 ppm. Next, to study the effect of pH, we vary the pH of phosphate solution from pH 2 to pH 10 using sodium hydroxide and hydrochloric acid. Lastly, we vary the thickness of beads from 0.2 gram to 1.5 gram. Water control, we made beads without calcium carbonate. This is to compare the effectiveness of absorption of phosphate with in the presence and absence of calcium carbonate.
Now, I'll be talking about the results and discussion. The characterization of the beads was conducted using FTIR and SEM. From the FTIR results, we identified the following functional groups, which are the CH, OH, CO, and C double bond stretch. Since these functional groups correspond to that of sodium alginate, we can conclude that sodium alginate and calcium carbonate has formed a composite material. This is the SEM image of one calcium carbonate composite bead. further medication. And C, sterile particles will provide a large surface area for the absorption of phosphate ions. In our project, we are mainly using these two formulas to find the removal efficiency in terms of percentage of phosphate removed, as well as absorption capacity in terms of milligram per gram of peat. As mentioned earlier, we'll be using beads without calcium carbonate as our control. Hence, we decided to compare the absorption capacity between our controlled beads and our composite beads. As you can see from the graph, for the different concentrations, the absorption capacity of our controlled beads is much lower. Hence, we decided to use a main video test to see if there's any significant difference between the absorption capacity. This will obtain a peak value of less than 0.05 for all the concentrations. We can conclude that there's a significant difference, and hence, the calcium carbonate plays a major role in the absorption of phosphate ions. Now, we're talking about the results obtained from the various independent variables. This is the raw data for us during the initial concentration of phosphate ions. From the graph, as you can see, as the initial concentration increases, the absorption capacity increases. To obtain a better correlation coefficient of close to 1, and conclude that there's a strong linear relationship between the two variables. The raw data for us during the pH of the solution. From the graph, the absorption capacity is generally higher in acidic environments and is optimal at pH 6. This is probably due to the fact that in alkaline environments, the hydroxide ions will compete with the phosphate ions for the binding to the calcium ions. However, wouldn't the calcium carbonate react in an acidic medium, and if so, what is still effective in removing phosphate ions? From experiments that we conducted, we realized that the change in mass of the beads before and after absorption is negligible. Hence, this is probably due to the fact that calcium carbonate in the beads are in excess and are still able to remove phosphate even after reacting with the hydrogen ions present in the acidic medium. Lastly, this is the raw data for us during the absorption dose. On the graph, as you can see, as the mass of beads increases, the removal efficiency increases until it remains relatively constant at 0.8 grams. Hence, the recommended mass of beads used will be 0.8 grams at 50 ppm of 25 ml phosphate solution.
And now, moving on to the application phase of our project. So, we constructed a working filter prototype, which contains 25 grams of alginate calcium carbonate composite beads to remove phosphate, 10 grams of fine sand beneath the beads to remove solid particles, and two layers of cloth at the bottommost layer to hold the filtration media in place. To experiment our filter, 100 ml of 50 ppm phosphate solution is passed through our filter, and the effluent is then analyzed to determine the remaining phosphate concentration using a chlorimeter. The effluent was then poured through the filter for up to 4 more times for maximum removal of phosphate, repeating the procedure for each dilution cycle. This is the raw data for my experiment. As you can see from the graph, as the number of dilution cycles increases, the percentage of phosphate removal also increases, and at the end of the fifth dilution, as much as 93.5% of phosphate is being removed. Therefore, our filter is very effective in removing phosphate. However, some limitations of our project include that we are not allowed to test on industrial wastewater in our laboratory. Therefore, we are only able to use synthetic wastewater, which is prepared using sodium dihydrogen phosphate solution for our experiment. To summarize our overall findings, the calcium carbonate plays a major role in the absorption of phosphate ions. The higher the initial concentration, the higher the absorption capacity. The absorption capacity of our composite beads are higher in generally higher in acidic environments, and the optimal pH is 6. The recommended mass of beads used is 0.8 grams in 25 ml of 50 ppm phosphate solution. And last but not least, the filter prototype constructor is able to remove up to 93.5% of the phosphate, and hence it's very effective in removing phosphate from wastewater. So in the future, we plan to conduct more extensive tests on the filter. We can determine the maximum amount of water we can treat, the reusability of the beads. We can test on the calcium content in the effluent, and you can also explore other designs for the filter, such as the modular design. These are references. We have come to the end of our presentation. Thank you.
ありがとうございました。それではせっかくの機会ですので、ご質問やいろいろな意見交換などなさっていただければと思います。どうぞ挙手をお願いできますでしょうか。何かご質問を聞いてみたいことなどございましたら。はい、ではマイクを中澤先生。
Thank you very much for the interesting results. That thoughts and thoughts coming, that all the different carbon, calcium carbonate beams, and you showed the dependence of the pH, and that the pH 6 is the best condition, right? And the phosphonate is the species, it is in several species, H3PO4, H2PO4-, H2PO4-, and PO4-. And what's the dominant species, the pH? And why, the next question is, why the pH 6 is the best condition? How do you think?
I believe it's because the pH 6 is the closest to neutral pH. As the calcium carbonate, the original calcium carbonate feeds will be less effective in a more acidic environment. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Another question. So what's the main species
of
the pH 6 of the phosphonate?
It's PO4-.
PO4-? Is the main species of pH 6? I don't believe it. Which species are absorbed of the calcium carbonate?
It's PO4-.
PO4- and pH 6. Okay, let's check the distribution. If you check the pH pKa, you can get the conclusion.
Okay, thank you. Okay, just a very simple question. So you concentrate on the alginate calcium carbonate composite beads as your target, right? So just a simple question, why you are so interested in this material?
Immobilizing alginate calcium carbonate into beads form is actually very sustainable and it's actually quite cost effective way of removing phosphate from industrial wastewater. That's why we choose register it. Yes.
それではお時間も参りましたので、以上とさせていただきます。ワンビーテックさん、ダレンディ・チーアンさんでした。どうもありがとうございました。